move to the next one. Start solving this question. I'll upload another one. These are the last two questions for today. Okay, are you getting 30 second option three? All of you? See, angular position is defined as, suppose this is the point for which you need to find angular position. Let's say this is the point. This point's angular position is this angle. Fine. That's how you define the angular position of a point on the screen. Okay. Now, if theta is the angular position, do you know that the path difference between these two is nothing but d sine theta? Okay. Which can be approximated to d tan theta as well. Fine. So let's say that, the path difference between these two is d sine theta. Okay. Now intensity has to be 1/4. So intensity formula is what? I is equal to 4I0 cos square phi by 2. Okay, 1/4 of the maximum intensity. Now maximum intensity is 4I0. So 1/4 of that is I0. So you can find out the value phi for which I becomes equal to I0 by using this formula. Okay, so you will get cos of phi by 2 to be equal to plus minus 1/2. Now plus minus 1/2 actually represent one point above and the other similar point below. So we'll just focus on the point above. So I'll just take the positive value over there. So pi by 2 should be equal to what angle? Pi by 2 will be equal to pi by 3. Okay. So the phase difference should be equal to 2 pi by 3. Fine. If phase difference is 2 pi by 3, what be the path difference? Path difference should be equal to lambda by 2 pi into phase difference. That's how you convert between phase difference and path difference, right? So this will be equal to lambda by 3. Fine. Now d sine theta, if you equate that to lambda by 3, you'll get theta is equal to sine inverse of lambda by 3d. That's why option 3 is correct over here. Fine. Now try out question number 33. All right. Anyone? 33. No one. Should I solve it? Okay. Let me solve it now. So I'll just briefly discuss this question. Probably then I'll leave it after that so that you can also do it your own. Okay, so first of all, PC is a wavefront. So P and C are the points on the same wave. Okay, hence P and C are in phase. Phase of P is equal to phase of C. Okay, now what happens? This point C moves forward, get reflected, and reaches P. Okay, so between this ray and this ray, okay, the path difference is CO plus OP, and because of hard reflection, lambda by 2. This is the path difference. Okay, so always take care of the reflection also. When there is a hard reflection, lambda by 2 you should add. All right, now CO and OP you can find out. OP is what? This angle is theta. Okay, so this d is given and here it is 90 degree. So OP you can write it as d divided by cos of theta is OP. Okay, and once you get OP, you have a 90 degree angle here as well. You can get CO as well. CO is OP cos of 2 theta. Okay, which is d by cos theta into cos of 2 theta. cos of 2 theta is cos square theta minus sine square theta. Okay, so you can use all that and then just substitute the value of OP and CO in this particular equation, and you need to have a constructive interference over here, right? So for constructive interference, delta x should be at least equal to lambda. So you can just put the value over here as lambda and then just simplify it and you will get the answer. I'll tell you the correct answer over here. 30th, the correct answer is this. 33rd. Okay, fine. So that's it for today from my side. So